HyperX released the Cloud Alpha wireless gaming headphones in April of 2022, and our friends over at Wired presented us with a puzzle. How did HyperX's engineers squeeze 300 hours of battery life into this thing? By comparison, most over-ear headphones land somewhere in the 30 to 50 hour region, meaning these headphones are up to 10 times more efficient. We are intrigued. Now, we tested these, we ran them for 65 hours, and they still had another 260 hours of life left in them. At this rate, you could run them for 2 weeks on a single charge. That's the equivalent of playing Call Me Maybe 62,790 times exactly on a single charge. We checked, it's true. How is this possible? Well, the exterior holds some clues. No lights, no gimmicks, not even active noise cancellation. There's a detachable external microphone, but that's it. Maybe minimalism and function can explain the spectacular runtime. Let's see what's inside this thing. The ear cushions come off easily enough. There's a thin mesh layer secured by double-sided tape to protect the drivers. It's easily removed by carefully peeling it back. Next, we undo the four Phillips screws. The cups aren't even glued down. Just apply a little force to separate it from the body. So far, so good. Now here's the first piece of the long life puzzle. The battery is on the larger side. At 5.5 watt hours, this battery is larger than average, but there's no sign of battery innovation here. As a comparison, the HyperX Cloud Flight can be fitted with a 5.5 watt hour battery and gets about 30 hours of playtime, while on the other end of the spectrum, the Audio-Technica ATH-S700BT uses a 0.9 watt hour battery and gets about 6 hours of playtime. The large battery certainly helps, but it's not the answer to this puzzle, so we'll have to look elsewhere. Let's check the other ear cup. Remove the foam cover and the four Phillips screws. This side is housing the motherboard held in place by three Phillips screws, but no battery cells. So 5.5 watt hours is all we have to work with. Impressive. We wanted to know if any of the chips were responsible for power savings, so we sent a picture of the board to one of our friends for chip ID. This is what we received. Sure enough, newer chips are being used, all of which are optimized for ultra-low power applications. The DA7212 Dialog semiconductor in particular uses newer generation amplifiers that are up to 70% more efficient. HyperX are by no means the first to use these chips, it's just one more power saving strategy that eventually adds up to that 300 plus number. Here's a theory. A larger than average battery, a super lean design combined with the latest power efficient chips. That's probably why this thing's running for 300 hours on a single charge. A theory's all good and well, but let's run some tests on a few headphones to flesh these ideas out a little. First up is the Sony WH-H800. These headphones are rated for 28 hours of playtime on a single charge. They come with active noise cancellation, which we'll refer to as ANC from now on. The ANC can be disabled with the push of a button, which again we'll make use of during our test. Here's the headphones playing white noise with ANC on. It's drawing around 32 milliamps, and here it is with ANC off, drawing 26 milliamps. So ANC uses up power, this isn't surprising, but to see how much power it draws is interesting. Now 6 milliamps might not seem like much, but it's the difference between 28 hours and 34.5 hours playtime. Let's take a look at the HyperX. We need to get to the battery leads to place our equipment in line with the battery so we can measure the draw while the headphones are running. They're drawing a measly 4.45 milliamps. Under ideal conditions, this battery could last over 330 hours. That's barely shy of 2 weeks of continuous playback. This is truly impressive. We performed the same test on the Beats Solo 3. Now, the reason we chose this headset is because it has a 1.5 watt hour battery that lasts for 40 hours. Now, in theory, if we were to put the same battery that the HyperX has inside this headphone, it would last for 150 hours. We thought that would be worth testing. The Beats Solo 3 has been optimized for efficiency, though notice how the power fluctuates wildly between 7.5 milliamps and 16 milliamps. It averaged to about 9.5 milliamps during our tests, which is around twice as much as the HyperX headphones. That's still half as much as most of its competitors. In conclusion, it isn't sorcery, just purposeful design decisions aimed at optimizing battery life. At least that's the fleshed out theory. We've reached out to HyperX for confirmation, and we'll let you know if they're willing to spill the beans. On the repairability side, we think HyperX deserves credit for figuring out how to significantly extend the battery life of this product. Regardless of your daily use, the battery in these headphones have the potential to last up to 10 times longer than its competitors. But here's the rub, the useful life of this battery will end, and when that happens, the replacement of this particular battery is going to be painful if you don't have soldering experience or if you don't have the equipment. The long battery life is fantastic, but it really should have been paired with a replaceable battery. The same can be said for the motherboard. The leads from the right ear cup are soldered onto the board, which means replacement of the board would again require some delicate soldering. Connectors of some sort would have been the repair-friendly solution here. Those issues aside, it was a cinch to get into these headphones. We're especially impressed with HyperX for not using any glue other than on the drivers where it was absolutely necessary.